They were called 100% Beef Cock and the Tit Burster. Gonna go. I don't even need that, I just wanted to prove that some of us still write things on paper. I wrote a blog the other day for Apples and Snakes. Apples and Snakes are wonderful, wonderful humans. And in it I was talking about, one of the things was about inspiration and where you get your inspiration from. And I genuinely believe that there is no such thing as like intellectual inspiration. You know, some of us can rewrite Greek myths and some of us can tell stories about insipid instances with Norwegian backpackers and stuff, but like most of us should just find it wherever we can, in the news, in other people's poems. I've been writing notes all night, and sitcoms is one for me specifically. Is anyone like Scrubs here? Have we got any Scrubs fans? One! It's like really famous! Okay, great. Has anyone seen that? So the last episode of Scrubs, before they did a rubbish ninth season, the concept behind Scrubs is that they have one protagonist, JD, who spends his life fantasizing about the things he wants to happen or that he fears happening. And then the final episode, the kind of finale, is him walking down a corridor and it's lined with all the people from his past. And when he gets to the end, he looks out the doors of the hospital he works in, and projected onto a screen is what he wants for the future. It's the Christmases he wants to spend, it's the best friend he wants to spend them with, and it's the woman that he wants to love. And playing over this is Peter Gabriel singing a song called The Book of Love. And the chorus goes, "And I love it when you give me things, and you could sing me anything." So, we could be honest. Fold our heartbeats into bacon sandwiches and make pancakes that promises. We could meet each other's families. We could shrug off jealousy. Pull on our cardigans made of cliches and seek out the most romantic places. Stand on bridges in the early evening, spit our worries onto car windscreens, and watch an unsuspecting face cloud beneath our spittle. We could get comfortable in our stubbled skin. We could not talk so much. We could not talk so little. I could teach you when to interrupt and you could tell me when to shut up. We could start listening more. We could not settle for the draw. We could pull our claws out of one another long enough to suture our wounds in bed covers. We could try hard not to hurt each other, so never argue just for the sake of it. We could stop worrying about things we can't control. We could leave words in each other's mouths and let all our pride outweigh our shame. We could remember our loved ones' names and feel no need to ink them into our arms because they're penned into our brains. We could accept that we're far from the same. We both like summer better than winter and hate when we're separated by trains. We could spend mornings in coffee shops, late nights in the library. We could watch Pulp Fiction, then You've Got Mail, and enjoy them equally. We could agree over The Cure, but argue over The Smiths. We could hide our faces at Halloween, play board games at Christmas. We could trip over our own teeth for the sake of a first kiss. We could sleep like old cutlery, simultaneously shut eyelids. We could accept that you look beautiful in a towel, and I look scruffy in pretty much all the clothes I own. We could accept that I make better beans on toast and that sometimes you just want to be alone. We could postpone an entire day's events so I could watch you paint murals around your eyes. We could tell one another to be alive and we could live properly for once. When I worry, I could text you a smile and an awkward sentence. We could phone our mothers more often. We could make jokes about having children, laugh at the fear graffitied on both our faces. We could remember that parents are staircases. The higher you climb, the more flaws you find. We could share in our achievements. And when the time comes, our bereavements. You could stroke my hair in the early evening, know when I'm sleeping by my shallow breathing. We could wake every morning and swap the stories of our sleep. Leave our screams in pajama pockets, and in our hands, hold our dreams.